Okay, so I know what you're probably thinking. Memeulous, this kid doesn't look so bad. What could he possibly say that's so bad? Just wait.
Yo, yes, like the bifter, I'm gonna raid your little sister.
Fucking hell.
PPE, PPN, you got bullied when you was in pen, look.
I bet this guy's installed like some fucking massive loud exhaust in his Vauxhall Corsa. So when he goes to like Tesco or something, it sounds like a fucking Boeing 747.
Mike, what? Top of the block, man, I get dropped cause I top of the beat. Don't give a fuck if you think you can fuck with me. Cause I come to the ends and I stack that P.
Oh yeah, Elder, I can tell you stack that P. You know, you can tell someone stacks bare P's when he's hanging around with a group of 11-year-olds and sharing a fucking cigarette with them.
Smithy yeah. Boy. L. Dot, the police car, man.
Okay, so it seems L. Dot and Smithy Boy have found a police car. And you know, it's obvious L. Dot and Smithy Boy have had some hardships with police in the past. You know, they've been very unjust towards them. Bloody hell, that's two whole weeds. How can you smoke two whole weeds? Surely you die of an overdose.
Why do you guys say I'm so excited? Are you actually excited every time? Yes, we are. We are very excited. Do British people not get excited about things? Is that not allowed?
Yeah, you're not allowed to be excited here. I mean, if you get caught smiling in public here, you just get taken to the Tower of London and executed. But really, there's not that much to be excited about here. I mean, all we've really got here are roadmen and a few kebab shops. I mean, I don't know how to play the guitar, but I think I still got my old recorder from year four somewhere. Would that work as well?
Trying better shit in his YouTube vids. My man's a myth, come off of this shit. Quiet if you don't get who's on a piff. Said quiet if you don't get who's on a spliff.
Okay, so I have no idea what is going on about here. Something about me crying about a spliff. I'm not too sure where Jam Dang did his research about me, but he got all these facts spot on. I definitely cry if I don't get twos on the spliff.
This shit good.
Said quiet if you don't get who's on a spliff.
Or whatever the fuck that is.
How do you like a guy sliding to your Snapchat?
I don't know, with an emoji or something.
Yeah, like what kind of emoji? Like the devil face?
Yeah, or the moon. I have to be different.
Oh, that's a good tip, lads. Don't just send your usual heart or kiss emoji. Be a little bit different. Make yourself stand out from the crowd. Well, I personally use a knife emoji, but I'll throw a few of my favourites up on screen right now. Lads, if you use any of these to slide into girls' Snapchats, you are guaranteed to pull. Alright, I'm just gonna straight up say it here. That kid doesn't look any older than 13. And that girl looks like she's in her early 20s. Now, I'm no expert on the law, but I'm pretty sure that's not legal. Like, this is some fucking Crime Watch shit. You lot are divs, bruv. The music is called grime and you calling us chavs. Damn, come down to my ends and say that. Fucking hell, this guy's obviously a certified roadman. Let's just check his channel real quick. Fucking hell, would you take a look at that Minecraft banner? This guy's obviously stabbed a couple people in his time.
Little sister's dating this guy, so they wanted to put him to the test.
This kid's mum's a fucking snake. I'm sorry. Who sets their 13-year-old son up in front of millions of people to see if he'll cheat? Like, if you want your son to lose trust in you, just pull some shit like this. But honestly, if that was my mum, I'd be straight on the phone to Childline.
Let's sing it now. Let's do the laundry.
Okay, so I probably know I should make a Bleach joke here, because you know Bleach is absolutely hilarious. Not an overused joke at all. I just gotta ask, why does it say safe to drink? Like, who's drinking Bleach if they actually want to live? Like, no one's actually gonna pour themselves a pint of Bleach and drink it. What is he doing with his voice? My mate, you don't need to go that high. You sound like someone just kicked you in the balls.
So how do you slide into a girl's Snapchat?
Yeah, your ping's still in it, like big back in it, like holla, done though.
Now, to me at least, that just sounded like a random combination of words. You know, if this guy says it works, then it must work. Yeah, your ping's still in it, like big back in it, like holla, done though. So as you can see, we've got some proper grime settings in this video. You know, we got Costa, KFC, and at some parts in the video, she's even in Lidl. Now, if a German discount supermarket isn't grime, then I really don't know what is.
Disgusting. I don't like you.
Oh, bloody hell, he doesn't like me. How am I ever going to deal with the fact that Ibby Sting doesn't like me? I mean, he's the only person I've ever seeked approval from. But now, in all seriousness, he said he doesn't like me about three or four times throughout this rap.
I don't like you, bro. I really don't like you. I don't like you.
Alright, mate, I get it. You don't like me.
Go, go, fuck.
Oh, my God.
Oh, hell no. Oh, hell no.
Look!
What the fuck?
He's not there. Go!
What the fuck?
Run!
Oh, well, that was uncalled for.
Oh, God.
To be honest, in that last video, I think they deserved it. Like, they were mildly rude to that clown.
What the hell's wrong with you?
And then you start talking, innit? And, like, when you feel ready, you just hit the bottom, like,
Where do you want to meet?
Why are there so many kids in these videos? Like, what would you do if you saw your little brother or son appear in one of Van Banter's videos like,
oh yeah, fam, basically, I seen in her Snapchat, was like, hey, yo, Wagwan Pifting, wanna be? And then we went behind Co-op and Buck, you get me?
Link me now, link me later. All that money, better get that paper.
All that money, better get that paper. I bet his nan just gave him like £100 for his birthday or something, and now he thinks he's balling. You know, he can get that new Razor scooter he wanted.
Yeah, if you best at Fort Josh, are you gay or who'd you like to suck?
I'm sorry, did you just call a 12-year-old gay over the internet? That's like the most year 7 thing you could do. I remember when you're in year 7 and the most deadly thing someone could say towards you is you're gay. Like, once someone said you're gay in year 7 to you, that was your secondary school career over. That, along with you're unique, was the biggest diss someone could send to you in year 7.
He lives, motherfucker. Let's go. Money.
Jesus Christ. So right from the start, we can see what kind of character 7K is. I mean, he's sitting at his dining room table, showing off his mum's benefits. And I mean, is there really a need for that much auto-tune? Like, how terrible must your voice be if you need that much auto-tune? Oh, and of course, he's got a gun sitting on the table, because, you know, he's hard. Now, that's the most gangster sight I've ever seen. A chubby guy standing in front of his uncle's Mercedes, with a fucking bandana and Sports Direct tracksuit on. I mean, you could have probably chosen some clothes that are a bit more gangster, mate. But you know, he's got that 100% genuine Rolex on, so that kind of makes up for it.
Why do you make women sit around and talk about men in movies
when y'all easily just sit around and talk about boobs for hours?
I'm really not too sure where BuzzFeed's getting this information from, but like, I don't just go around my mate's house and go, Terry, mate, boobs.
Oi, oi, love me some fucking boobs, I do fucking hell. Oh yeah, boobs, they're just the fucking greatest, aren't they?
Why do you always ask to have a white people club?
Who the fuck's ever asked that? Like, when I was at school and everyone like did lunchtime clubs and that, I didn't go up to the teacher and go, Miss, can we have a club for only white people? And also in America, I'm pretty sure you already do have a white people club.
Why do you see the success of people of color as a threat to you?
We fucking don't. Like, I've never seen a black person win an award and thought, oh, that's fucking threatening that. Okay, so real quick before I say anything, big up to my boy Scythe. Like, he edited that little compilation you just saw, and honestly, I reckon it was pretty fucking sick. So yeah, I'll leave all his links down below, be sure to check him out. But anyway, I originally planned to put this video up as like a 250,000 subscriber special, but I think I'm a little bit late. Like, the channel's probably only a few days off hitting 300k. And honestly, 1 year ago, I never thought I'd be making this video. Never in a million years. Like, around this time 1 year ago, I was working in a kitchen, like, washing up and shit, and I was doing a course at college that I didn't really have that much interest in. And like, while I was on that college course, I was like, what am I gonna do after this course finishes? Like, I didn't really have any actual plans after. Like, chances are I would have probably just gone back to college and done something different, or maybe taken a gap year or something. And honestly, I'm pretty happy I didn't have to go back to college, because I really didn't know what I wanted to do with my life. And if I went back to college, it would have cost me like $5,000 a year or something, and that can piss off. That's almost as much as fucking uni. But I also remember talking to one of my mates at the start of this year when I was only around like 40 or 50k, and I remember he asked me like what my goal for the end of the year was. And I said, I know I'm pushing it a little bit here, but 100k subscribers. And he was like, mate, I reckon you could get 250k. And I was like, piss off, mate. Like, that, there's no chance of that. So I went on through the year and my channel didn't really experience that much growth. And it even got to the point where I thought I might have to give this YouTube thing up, because like, my parents were pushing on me to get a proper job, and I thought I might have to go back to college for another year or whatever. And I don't think I would have had enough time to fit YouTube, a job, and college in. And then I remember it was around late July time. I was just browsing my computer, like reading comments, and I suddenly noticed that I was getting a lot more comments than usual. So I was like, what's going on here? And I checked my real-time view stats, and they just fucking skyrocketed. Like, I went from getting around 2,000 views an hour to 25,000 views an hour in a matter of hours. And honestly, I'm so grateful for this position you guys have put me in. And I know this is gonna sound proper cringy, but without you guys, I genuinely wouldn't be doing something I love for a living. And like, recently the channel's been growing at a mad rate. So yeah, massive thanks to you guys for everything. Okay, so now my little sentimental bits out of the way, I want to just talk about something real quick. I know loads of YouTubers have made like full videos on this, but I didn't really want like a full video on this because like, everyone's already said most of the things I was gonna say. But YouTube's been unsubscribing a lot of you guys apparently. Like, I'm getting 20, 30 comments and tweets a day from people saying they've been unsubbed, and you know, that's a bit shit. But to be fair, I think YouTube are working on fixing it, which is good, I guess. So yeah, I'm just gonna plug my Twitter right now. Like, go over and follow that. If you ever get unsubbed to me for some reason, then you always find out about my new videos through Twitter, because whenever I upload a video, it automatically posts a tweet onto my Twitter. So, you know, I thought I'd just quickly say something about it there. So, yeah, guys, once again, thank you for all the support recently. And as always, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Remember to check out my boy, Scythe. His links will be in the description, and I'll put a link to his channel in the outro. And, yeah, anyway, guys, as I said, I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, be sure to subscribe and smash that motherfucking like button.